Let's build some forms. Of course, in Orchard, you can create forms from codes, so from your module or even from your team. You can create forms in any way that you want them, from CSS HTML, the Razor templates, Liquid templates, or else. But for simpler forms, there is also a nice built-in feature in Orchard called Forms. So we'll use that to create a simple form, like a simple contact form from the admin, and handle the postback with workflows and with Liquid, as we have seen in the previous tutorial. So let's see. Back in the admin, we will have to enable the forms feature because it's not enabled by default. So let's do that. We already have the workflows features enabled, otherwise you need them too. And now that we have this, nothing really changes here, but we will be able to create forms with flow part from, for example, pages. So just as we have created a simple layout from a page before with flow part, which is still this area here, we can create a form too, because now we have the form widget. And by the way, we also have the input and label and a few other widgets for form specifically. So let's do that. This won't be a complete example of a contact form. This will be just the very basics and the beginning of that. But starting from here, you will be able to go further. And of course, there is documentation. So here is some documentation about using the forms feature. As you can see, pretty thorough documentation. And there is also documentation on how to handle the postback with Liquid here. Well, here is how to access the data from the request in Liquid, which we'll utilize in workflows. So let's create a contact form, and let's call it something like contact us. And here we will create the form within the flow part of this page. So let's add a form. This widget here will be a container, so something we haven't seen yet, but this is a widget that will contain other widgets. So we can give it a title. That's not really necessary, but we can call it contact us. And then action. This action will need to be the URL of the workflow that we'll use later. So for now, I will just leave it empty. Now the method should be, well, post, because we are actually changing something on the server. The encoding type can remain like this. Let's require an anti-forgery token too. You know, anti-forgery token is about cross-site request forgery prevention. It's a built-in feature of ASP.NET. So nothing else to do here yet. And now that we have the form ready, let's also add some form fields to it. Like, I will add, but actually I can click here, since this is a container widget, I can click here and add something directly to it. Well, let's add an input widget. And since you are building a contact form, Let's start with one of the basic ones. This can be a form field for the person's name, for example, but just not to confuse all the names here, I will create one for the subject line. So in the end, we can send an email from this contact form submission. Let's imagine that it will contain a proper subject line too that the user can specify. So the name will be subject. The ID, well, you can disable the HTML ID. It's not really necessary to specify here unless you want to style it. Type, we have some built-in types. For emails, for example, we would use email. Yep, a lot of types, as you can see. I will just use simply text here. The placeholder text can be specified as well. You know, the placeholder that is displayed as a ghosty text within the form field. That can also be specified. Well, let's specify it. As well as a default value, but we won't need a default value. And we can add a lot more things here. So we could add labels for these fields to make it a bit more user-friendly. We could add other input fields for the name, the email fields, and an input field for the actual message too. So lots of things. There is one thing that we'll add though, is a submit button. And now I recognize that I put this input widget into the wrong place. It should actually be in the contact form. And now we can put this input widget under the contact form. We just need to be careful to put it here. And now it's within the form, as you can see. So it's contained within the form. That's what we wanted. Yeah, and now let's also add a submit button to this form, which will be an input widget still. It can be just, we can just call it submit. Oops. ID we won't need, but the type should be submit. Placeholder text, not really necessary. Nothing really. Well, we can give a value to it. And let's drag it below the input field so we have a nice form. And now let's publish it. And let's open it. And you will see that our form is, well, it's not very nice, but it is displayed. I mistakenly pulled the submit button outside. So let me refresh here. Yeah, so now it's a bit nicer. But of course, if I do something, nothing will happen because we don't handle the postback yet. So let's fix it. And what I will do now is that the form is ready. I will create a workflow type and I will hook up the two things next. So let's create a workflow. A workflow type, sorry, important. And this will be the postback handler of our contact us form. So let's call it contact us handler, for example. And everything else can be on default. Again, we need an event that will start the workflow. And in this case, we will use HTTP request because we need to post the form somewhere. And this request should be a post one since we configured the same thing for the form. And we have the URL too. So that will be handy. I will copy it. This URL, as you can see, also includes a token. So it's kind of a password that's included here. If you just know the basic URL, you won't be able to run this workflow, which of course would be a security issue. We want to validate the anti-forgery token because remember on the form we specified that an anti-forgery token should be included. And the token lifespan should be infinite because we don't want to regenerate this this URL and reconfigure the form every time. So this is enough. Again, we have to set this as a startup task. And then we can actually handle the postback. Now, this is the step where we could send out an email, even save the submission to the database or something like that. To keep things simple, I would just create a notification again that will display the subject. So for that we'll need a task, and again I will use the notify task. Again, it can be subject. And now the message. It just as kind of debugging, so we know that it works. I will display it like this. And the Liquid support is there for retrieving the subject field's value from the request, which, as I said, is documented on the documentation site. But it is like this. First, we need to access the form itself, and then the field based on its name. Yes, and now we have to hook them up. So the done income of the HTTP request event up to the notification task. All right, and now let's go back to our form. And let's fix it. I still have the URL of the request, of the workflow's request, on my clipboard. So now it is here. Do know that this is a relative URL. So even if you deploy the site somewhere, it won't run on localhost. This will keep on working. Yeah, and let's publish it. And not confirm resubmission because the URL changed. So let's refresh the site and let's add the subject here. Of course, demo. And nothing happened. What happened here? As we can see, the workflow or the form was posted properly to this URL, but the issue is that we didn't actually do anything after that. So, okay, the notification was displayed somewhere, but we didn't actually redirect the user anywhere. Now, if I hit F5 here to refresh, we also get this confirm form resubmission warning. And all of this is the issue specifically that post redirect pattern is a solution for. So super simple, you handle the post back and then you redirect the user somewhere. Now the good thing is that there is also a task built into workflows for redirection called HTTP redirect. You may have guessed that it's something like that. And here you have to specify the location. You could have some kind of nice thank you page built under a specific URL and redirect users there. What I will do here will be super simple. I will just redirect them to the homepage. And well, not entirely important, but still the proper configuration is here to not make this redirect permanent, because we are not redirecting because a resource moved, but rather we always want to do the same redirection, a similar redirection, but with different URLs for the user. All right, so now we also have the redirect here. And let's go back here and let's actually resubmit the form. And now we are also redirected to the home page, and we actually get the message with the proper subject line. As again, this was just a very basic example. There's a lot more to it. You can also make the form a lot more complicated. You can add a lot more fields. You can add the fields with different types, as you can see. And all of these will also display their own editor. So if you display, for example, a date field, then you will get a nice date picker. Similarly with file, you can also let users upload files, etc., etc. The forms feature of Orchard is still a bit limited, so you can't just build any form with it, with any kind of postback validation and management behind the scenes. You can do a lot of things. At one point, it's just easier to do it from code. We will also see how to create your own module, of course, so don't worry. But for simpler forms, or if you just want to quickly throw something together on an existing website without having to write code and deploy it and etc., etc., this is definitely a viable solution. And Workflows, of course, is very powerful, so there are a lot of options to handle this postback too. We have seen simple ones, but apart from sending out emails, you can also save content, create content items, save content items, invoke webhooks, or whatever else that you integrate with Workflows. Because again, Workflows, as pretty much everything in Orchard, is extensible. So in your own module, you can also write, for example, workflow tasks, or have your own custom workflow events.